Welcome back to another episode of Focus on Fond du Lac. Today we are visiting Fives, Giddings, and Lewis. Yes, guys, trust me, it's Fives, it's not Fives. So come on in and let me show you all the great things this company is up to right now. Giddings and Lewis has had its roots in the Fond du Lac community since 1859. In that time, they have always been at the Highway 23 Doty Street location. In 2013, French group Fives acquired the Meg Americas companies, which included G&L. The acquisition may have changed the name and the logo colors a little bit, but the company still provides the same stellar service to its customers all over the world. This is Military Road. Well, at one time it was. Back in the day, G&L was separate buildings divided by Military Road. Now, this area is known as the Tunnel. The employees here don't just make machines and machine parts. They make huge machines and huge machine parts. These machines can take months to assemble. And once they're assembled, they have to be tested, taken back down for shipping, and then built back up again at its new location. The people building machines here are the same people who will rebuild the machine in a different part of the country or even the world. Everywhere you look, parts are either being made or they're ready to be assembled into machines of all sizes. If you're wondering what type of machines G&L uses to make products, they use their own. Where else were they going to get such massive equipment? This is Kevin, Vice President and General Manager of Fives. We were happy to get him for a few minutes to find out more about this well-known company.
G&L was founded actually right on the corner of Johnson and Doty Street back in 1859. And we started making metal cutting machine tools that you saw during your tour of the plant today in about 1903. So the time between 1859 and 1903, we made machinery that actually serviced the log processing, wood processing industry. And of course, we had a lot of trees and forests here back in that time and cut it all down for the sake of progress. And when the wood was gone, we started changing to metal. And that's when G&L really came along with the product that we're known for today. The process is really something that has been developed over that 150 years or so that we've been in existence. So, we've got a proven recipe, if you will, for building a machine. We try to do a good job of actually documenting that process as well, so that it's very repeatable. And typically from the time that we quote a project until we win an order is about a 6 to 7 month time span. And once that order is won, we have a process that we go through to summarize the order. We basically communicate that order to the shop. And then our engineering team will release a bill of materials. Our purchasing team goes out and buys all the equipment, all the components that we use to make the machines. And then we have a skilled group of assemblymen and women who put the machines together. And usually the time span of a machine on our floor being assembled is less than 2 months. You know, the culture is one of the things that I kind of fell in love with when I interviewed here 25 years ago. It's very much a family atmosphere, and we try to take care of each other. This culture is important to our customers as well. Many people buy from G&L not just because we have the best machine tools in the world, but because they want to work with our people.
Thank you to all of you who have continued to watch our episodes of Focus on Fond du Lac this year and who have helped make it a great success. This is our last episode for 2014, but don't worry. In 2015, we will be back with new unaired episodes, as well as a blooper reel, new videos that we will be filming very shortly, as well as a new spin-off series that you will just have to wait and find out more about. So make sure that you're following us on your favorite social media channel to get all the scoop of what's coming up next. And as always, I'm Sarah with FCEDC, and we'll see you next time.